went for a medical assessment recently, nothing serious, quite a standard medical assessment, just sort of height and weight and blood pressure and heart rate, that sort of thing. But I wasn't really looking forward to the weight bit because I don't have scales at home, I don't believe in them. I do have kitchen scales now, and I'd be lying if I said I hadn't weighed anything of myself in them. Left one's heavier, interesting. But I don't have bathroom scales. I don't think it's healthy. Why would I do something every day that makes me feel a bit shit? So I do instead. I think a lot of people do this. It's a much healthier way of doing it. You just judge it on your clothes, don't you? Judge it on your clothes. And then when your clothes start getting a bit tight, you think, well, maybe it's time I went out and bought bigger clothes. So I told the doctor I wasn't really looking forward to the weight, but he said, we still have to do it. I said, no, I understand. I'm just trying to think of a way to make it a bit more fun. And he said, well, what do you suggest? I said, well, how about this? Simple as this. How about I guess my own weight? And he said, okay, we can do that. So I guessed my own weight and I got it right and I was fucking thrilled. And he just went, nobody's ever been that happy about being that weight before. Which I thought was a little mean. So I said back, perhaps too loudly. And also, I don't know where this came from. It just fell out of my mouth. I just went, it's more important to be right than to be thin. Feels like I might have read it on a T-shirt. I don't know where that came from. But if that's going to be my mantra, that's quite a good mantra, isn't it? It's much better than what Kate Moss said. I don't know if you know this. Kate Moss, the model, said, nothing tastes as good as skinny feels. Let me just say that to you again so it can probably sink in all of your heads. She said, nothing tastes as good as skinny feels. And I thought, well, she's obviously never had millionaire shortbread, has she? And my response to her would be, nothing looks as good as not being a cunt. But I live on my own. Give us a woo if you live on your own. A few of you do. You might not know this if you live on your own. You can still have breakfast in bed. What I do if I fancy breakfast in bed, just before I go to bed, I put a Twix on the bedside cabinet. And then when I wake up the next day, as my eyes are focusing, I think, there's a fucking Twix just there. But sometimes there's just a wrapper. I've obviously got up for a wee in the night, haven't I? Either that or the tooth fairy's moved over to the dark side. I like going shopping, but I don't find shopping very relaxing. What normally happens is I go in a shop that I like, I try on some clothes that I like, most of them won't fit, and I walk out shouting something along the lines of, oh, so I'm an 18 in here. Well, fuck off. And then I have to go and buy a handbag to calm down. Because you're never too fat for a handbag. They've got those ones that have just got the short straps and they just go right under your arm. You think it's just a matter of time before I have to get buttered out of a handbag. And I know what I'm talking about as well because I was once cut out of a dress in Monsoon. That wasn't my favourite day. The lady said, I'll just go and get the scissors. Why are you crying? Dress for the rest of my natural life and I don't even know if I fucking like it. I stopped buying women's magazines. About 6 months ago I stopped buying women's magazines because it feels like there's nothing in there for me. I might as well be buying a magazine about yachts. There's just nothing in there for me. Why would I buy anything? Well, the only time I ever see anybody who looks a bit like me is underneath the word before. Magazines always maintain that they're about improving women's lives and it's bullshit because they never tell you just to see your friends more often or to read more books. It's always the physical things that we're supposed to do to ourselves. And the list of those things is quite ridiculous. You can have your eyebrows waxed, your eyelashes tinted, your skin darkened, your teeth lightened, manicures, pedicures, cleansed, tone and moisturised. I'm 38, I've cleansed, I've moisturised. I've no idea what toning actually is. Does anybody give us a woo if you do? A few of you. Does anyone want to shout out what it is? No. I'll woo, but I'm not explaining it to her. like makeup. I like wearing makeup. I like wearing it on stage. I like wearing it if I go out somewhere nice. But I don't think I need to wear it all the time. And I don't think I look weird if I don't have any on. I still don't really understand why I paint over naturally rosy cheeks to then apply rosy cheeks. Like, hair removal is a whole subject all in its own, isn't it? There's so many different ways, especially as women, that we can remove our hair. You can wax, you can shave, you can pluck, you can epilate. My sister had laser treatment. Laser treatment, which is supposed to be permanent. She had it to her underarms. It was quite painful and quite expensive. And after 2 months, the whole lot just grew back in. Which is terrible, but does go some way to explaining why James Bond was always so nonchalant when a laser was aimed at his cock and balls.
Come back in a couple of months, man, I'll be champion.
Realise I've made James Bond a Geordie. Maybe that's the future. Few cheers for a James Bond that's Geordie, how nice. But according to women's magazines, there are only two options for hair down there for women. One of my friends said to me recently, she said, you know why women are supposed to have hair down there, don't you? And I said, is it like your nose, so you don't get muck up it? And she said, no. She said, women are supposed to have hair down there so that nature knows where your reproductive bits are. I said, why does nature need to know? Surely as long as me fella's got a rough idea, why do all the deers and the rabbits need to know? Well, maybe the rabbits. But I decided about 6 months ago now to try to sort of better myself. And I'm not really bothered about losing weight, but I quite like the idea of getting fit. So I thought I'd get myself an exercise DVD. Now, you know when your partner goes shopping and they say, do you want anything? And they want you to say no, but instead you give them a list. I love doing that. Sometimes I just make shit up I don't even need. Just to see the look on his face. He looks at the list and he goes, what's the difference between a tangerine and a satsuma? It's a test. So I said, could you get us an exercise DVD, please? Just a basic one, like a bog standard, like a beginner's guide. And he said, no problem. And he came home with Davina's Buff Your Abs. And I thought, well, I'm going to have to lose 3 stone before I can find me fucking abs. So I took it back to the shop and I swapped it for the one that I wanted, which was, you know, just fat lass has a go. For the sequel, fat lass tries again. And I watched the first few minutes. And you know how it's always a celebrity and a trainer, isn't it? Because the celebrity is the one that sells the DVDs and the trainer is the one that knows what they're doing. I watched the first few minutes. They were both laughing at nothing. It was very unnerving. And the trainer said to the celebrity, viewers at home what weight you were when you started this regime. And the celebrity went, but I started this regime. I started this regime. I was 10 stone. I realised then that I'm aiming for her start weight. But my friend said to me, just get some exercise equipment. If you buy it, you've got it at home, you'll use it all the time. And I thought, bless her cotton socks, she's got no idea, has she? That's not how it works at all, is it? I've got a cross trainer that I've had for 3 years. I've used it twice and I've got the feet level so I can put books on them. But my friend said, get a treadmill. She said, treadmills are really good. Give us a cheer if you've never owned a treadmill. Exactly, because we clearly know something that she doesn't, that you can still have the benefits of a treadmill without having to actually buy a treadmill. All you need is some socks and a slippy floor. What we'll do is we'll be sitting side by side on the sofa, me and me fella. He'll get up to get something, probably a packet of biscuits. And when he gets up, I just hold on to the back of his pants. And he does this for a bit. And then I twang it back into place. He gets some exercise. I get a look at his arse. Just like in a proper gym.
Hello, it's Sarah Millican here. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Don't forget to like, pop a comment below, and why not stick around to watch a few more? I'm sure those emails or those dishes can wait a bit longer.